My name is Taylor Penke. I'm a third-year graduate student in the Genetics and Molecular Biology program at UNC Chapel Hill. So what I'm very interested in studying is understanding how our DNA is organized within the nucleus of a cell. And understanding this fundamental process will help us understand when something is going wrong, what's going wrong, and how can we fix this to make it right. First got interested in earth science. And later on during a genetics course in my undergraduate career is when I really became interested in the life sciences. It was in a genetics course in my sophomore year of undergraduate when we first began to learn about the different sequencing techniques and this brand new technology to look at the human genome and how those techniques were developed and how they are being used was what really sparked my interest. One of the really fascinating things about the DNA in our cells is that if you were to lay it end to end and stretch it out, it would be as long as I am tall. And so the cell needs some way to pack this very long amount of DNA into a microscopic nucleus. And so this process is absolutely fascinating. And one of the things that our lab and our group is trying to understand is how this compaction occurs. So what we're looking at here are polytene chromosomes, and they're a special type of cell in which a bunch of chromosomes align into one structure, and so it forms a really large, easily visible structure underneath the microscope. And so we use these chromosomes to look at different regions of the genome, so we can look at how chromatin is organized throughout the genome or where different proteins are binding. We can look at how chromatin is organized at these different positions in the genome. So we work with fruit flies in our lab, and so a part of my day I spend taking care of those flies, taking care of those different stalks. So I spend about half my time doing bench work, so doing different molecular biology techniques or biochemistry techniques. Yeah, I usually take 75 to 100 and we'll probably get 10 to 15 out. Yeah, hopefully it'll work out.
Is this going to be for a seed?
Some of these experiments generate very large data sets, so I spend about the other half of my day doing some computational work to try to analyze these large data sets. Some of the experiments we do are biochemical in nature, so taking, isolating the proteins out of the flies and then performing various assays on them, or molecular biology techniques where we're looking at the DNA of these flies. Collaboration occurs on a daily basis in our lab. It's very important. There's a lot of different groups that are developing small molecules or different drugs that if we can identify different therapeutic targets of something that's going wrong in these different diseases, then some other groups can take over from our work and can, I guess, guide them to or give them clues to some options for treating these various diseases. As scientists, we want to improve the quality of life for some group of individuals. It's our major goal. And so while we're doing research at a very basic level studying the fruit fly, a lot of these very important fundamental cellular processes work similarly in humans. And so our understanding at a basic level will help guide therapeutic interventions into various human diseases. That challenging aspect of science is what makes the rewards of success so much better.